I wanted to test the tkinter-tooltip library that I've talked about in the previous video. The problem is that I had some issues with the library in my system. I don't know what the problem is, so I decided to use Replit, a software development platform, and I use it because right now this is the only platform that I found that can run tkinter code. So with it, I can create GUI interfaces using the tkinter library. So first, after the welcome message, because this is the first time I'm using this platform with this account, so I installed the library pip install tkinter-tooltip, and then I start writing the code. First I thought that I was going to write the code, then I remembered that there are examples of use of the library in the library page itself. So I just copied the first code, which is simple. GUI with the window with the button, and the button with the button is associated a tooltip. So the first run is takes longer than the others, but then after that it will be okay. So it worked. The tooltip worked. So the first example created a class tooltip, defined a message, and that's all. And now I'm going to use another example. I will change only the tooltip statement, in which I'm going to add a delay. This is the delay in which the tooltip will be shown. There is another example which says to make the tooltip follow the mouse, but it's set to true by default, so I will not test it. The other one is to call a function instead of setting a message. So this function requires the time library, so I imported the time library. And then I run the code again, and now it shows, instead of a message, the time, the actual date and time when you hover the mouse on the button. Then I tested the last example, which is theming the tooltip. So you theme the tooltip, you can also theme the button, of course. And since in the page they are using a TTK button, so they use the TTK style to style their buttons. The background of the button will be black, and the tooltip background also is set to black to match the selected theme. Now to see if it's really related to the button, I change the background color to red. And you can see that it changed only the background color of the button, but not the styling of the tooltip. So it really works. Now I have to make it work on my system. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.